about 5 minutes just before you go on and you watch the band start getting into their zone and you're hearing all the music buzzing. It really is a trip.
It's unlike anything else. It really is unlike anything else. To see the reaction and to hear the same Hilltop chant that I've heard over the years get louder and thicker, and now it's at a stadium capacity sound. It's just crazy.
I'm the one that sets off the whole show. It's exhilarating to start the set and just watch everything part.
When you're performing live, you do have this, it's like an energetic connection with the crowd. It is this transferal of energy.
And it pours out of them, not in just like, you know, an existential idea of energy, people like physical energy, like heat coming from the crowd and, you know, objects coming from the crowd and shit like that. Like, the energy exchange there as well.
It's the reason I love performing live. It's crazy. Melbourne, put your hands in the air. These days I've been broken and hopeless, and I don't feel like I'm broken, and I'm hoping that I can live and let go, so I can get through this, so I can live and let go, so I can get through this. You know the pain can hang in the air like singing with smoke, right? Sometimes trying to live and let go, trying to talk with a mouth full of cinnamon bowl, trying to cool out the skin of my soul. I can see it through the eyes of a loved one, eyes of an enemy, rising above some time since a pedigree. That I feel that I don't possess, turns hope into hopelessness, but I'm born repressed. Won't let life wear me down, staring down until troubles all rush by. Some part there where we frown, but where I frown like a handlebar mustache. So I live by forgive and forget, rather die than to live with regret. It's not living with death. I guess when we started with the Drinking from the Sun, Walking Under Stars Restrung, we knew it was a massive project. We'd done the Hard Road Restrung 8 years ago, but we did it in a very different fashion and we never took it around the country on a tour either. So we knew it was big, but I don't think we knew how big. And at one point we kind of went, shit, I think we've probably bitten off more than we can chew.
I kind of feared it because I knew it would be tenfold on what we did last time. But looked forward to being able to go back and do something we've done before on a larger scale.
It doesn't start like when we meet the orchestra. It started 18 months ago when we were going back and forth on the arrangements with Jamie. I mean, the term moving parts comes up a lot in our conversations, but it's true, there's lots of moving parts, and to bring those all together into something that makes sense is a challenge.
This concept in particular has been one that's been talked about for a very long time. The band did it in 2007 with the Adelaide Symphony Orchestra, and then the concept came up of let's do it national and let's also do it with an album. Once you start working in it, you realise how many players are involved, from, you know, the venues to the promoter, the publicist, the manager, the agent, and then the band themselves, the production elements. There's, you know, it's a lot of moving parts.
An acapella, we don't have accompaniments, so having the big arena and all of the sound gear has taken some time to get used to, but get it in.
You're our first hip hop.
We're all out of
And again, last one.
Yay!
I'm wondering where the day went.
Hold up, I don't think they heard you, sir.
Mr. Messenger. I'm wandering with the day. The clouds have me shrouded in grey, but I'm still out pounding the pavement.
What?
Drowning the herb, I'm pounding around some brown paper. Found out a label, now I'm drowning in paper.
Work.
But now the calm down, we found an escape from work. And I love it, cause that's where your hard work gets you. My heart bursts through my chest, I'm rescued. So forget what the rest do, I'm blessed to do it to who with the best to do it to I love it.
Look at it goes, if we never stood in the cold, we wouldn't evolve. Used to put my crooked foot in what I couldn't resolve. It took control now, hard work is good for the soul.
And I love it.
Grumbling through life with stress, knowing the fight is just half a self-imposing a righteousness. Contract, owners and licenses, troubles and lights. We just searching for that moment of pricelessness.
Oh,
his eyes, he can ask the crowd. Then we passing out at a departure lounge. Yeah. I love it, I hug the road like an old friend, love the world, vulnerable. That's a role that honor the hope, they're honor the soul. Melodic and old, they wanted it. I love it, we're chasing the dream. Every day a new place, new faces and scene. Living out a suitcase, few breaks in between. There's been very few days that lose faith in my team. I got love.
The rehearsals are absolutely essential because we used a different orchestra and a different choir everywhere we went. So, you know, you can't just step on stage with 40 people you've never played with before. It just doesn't work.
Because we don't get much rehearsal time with the orchestras, there's a lot riding on getting it right. It's not like you go in there going, is this going to work? It's just like, how tight can we get it?
We never normally, for a Hood show, do that sort of level of rehearsal. The rehearsal's usually done at the Breeze studio, but couldn't fit them all in.
It's my OCD coming out.
Dean has the hardest job here. He's got to keep 50 people happy.
Each orchestra is going to be different too, so the biggest thing about our job is to make sure that everyone feels comfortable on the stage and can hear themselves.
Ladies and gentlemen of the orchestra, your attention, please welcome your conductor, Hamish McKee.
The master on beat one.
I mean, any collaboration from entirely different music worlds, let alone genres, is always interesting.
Sometimes what can happen is that the band or whoever has an orchestra, it just becomes like a backing track. But in this case, you know, space has been given for the orchestra to get in there. There's an orchestra on stage. You don't want them to sort of be invisible.
It's just trying to marry those two worlds. I mean, really, that's what makes or breaks a show like this. And as soon as it gets it, you know, they get it right, it's magic.
Imagine, you know, having 30, 40 musicians behind you playing all different elements of a song and how powerful that may feel.
But when you can actually see that person playing it, you can feel the horns, you can see the strings, and you can identify with the noise that each instrument is making in its own right.
We all take our jobs very seriously in what we owe to the music community. We're lucky to have a job where we play music all the time, and as a result, we take it very seriously that every time we get out and play, we play really, really well.
These are all massively accomplished musicians. For them to, you know, take their craft and put it into something so fresh. They may have never, you know, been involved or experienced before playing-wise. Yeah, it's a really great thing to be part of.
I think an orchestra's got an amazing ability to take something and enhance it. It takes in an emotive song and just gives it that drama that you sort of feel in your bones, that, you know, elevates it to that sort of level that gives you that spine-tingling feeling. They've willingly gone out of their way to adapt to us. It's been amazing.
A little slower here. The pain builds cause the summer's here is so severe. And we're nowhere near, nowhere you would know of. Look us here right, they show up just to show off. Oh man, take a load off just to watch a day go by. Philosophizing with the friends like the brain toe. They prophesize on the bench by the main road. Right, got advice, I'm like, hey, would you say so? Guys, what do they know? Fox News got them lit, they're shook. Cause fundamentalist, the new communist. Or girl with the shopping list, clutch a handbag close. I'm like, damn, man, then it's all back has shows. Cause I'm a gentleman, then again, most of us are. First their faces in the back, the post office, the bar, the course of the park. Lady, I ain't trying to grab your bed shut. Yes, Melbourne. Well, check it out. Hey, hey, one more thing, let's go. A little slower here. Takes us like a week, it feels like it could go a year. And we're nowhere near nothing, man, it's so true. Don't tell him where I'm from, I tell him where I'm close to. And I can go through an atlas, show you on a map, but you still look at me sideways and treat me like I'm backwards. That's just fine, it so happens. I'm happy living in a city that is trapped in time. While you're lined up in traffic, I'm not. If I'm trans, then I'm back in time for a TV dinner and an early night. We get dressed to travel, got an early flight. We do a lapse of the earth, do a lapse of the sun. Try to put where I'm at on a map, cause where I'm from, we never get a mention. But all that and then some. Please make some noise for Montaigne, ladies and gentlemen. And you know what? Montaigne, let's go.
When we were kids, we hadn't really traveled much. We just wanted to play music, and to be able to go interstate and play it was like a pretty big deal for us.
Touring is a massive deal going interstate. I'd never been in a plane before.
I think I remember our first show in Sydney. I think it was at Bar Broadway.
Which was actually a really cool show. I think there's like 100 people there, which for us was massive back then. And then he took us down south to an RSL, which we played to about 3 disgruntled people that wanted us to keep it down because they were trying to play the pokies.
The first night I went out, I met these dudes and I was baptized with fire. They came from the same school of battle rap as us, so you'd go to a cypher, you'd go to a crew of dudes and they'd all be in the middle just freestyling and who was the sickest freestyler. So we met on that level. The first night I ever went out, I met them after hours, Crossbred Mongrels, dudes who were still super influential and a big part of this whole journey to today.
So you'd hear word of mouth about certain groups from certain areas and Hilltop Hoods is the Adelaide crew. When the Hoods broke through with Dumb Enough and Nosebleed Section, you knew that local hip-hop had arrived on a major scale, and the people that weren't necessarily into hip-hop saw the Hoods, and they could, you know, they saw 3 guys that looked like them, or they could have went to school with, or they knew, and automatically a lot of people related and just struck a chord with the majority of, like, suburban kids.
We can fire on the nightlife, Prince Harry, but the high life, we can fire, we can. like a white line hanging from behind that we're just married. I turn the art form into a blood sport. Make peace through battle for people. They want to run these streets like parkour. I'd rather run these tracks like a sea train. Like a sea train. Like a sea train. Like a sea train. Like a sea train.
Is that me?
I know, thanks for coming, guys. It's fun. We see you power up at
this. Oh, right, right, right. Okay.
Good luck tonight.
Thank you. Yeah. See you there. Bye.
That's some definite Adelaide hometown shit like that.
I feel like it's a massive compliment, the broad demographic of age of people that we had at these concerts.
When we sign stuff after a show, for instance, I've had a 5-year-old kid come up to me and then the next person in line asking me to sign the hat to a 65-year-old.
I think it's amazing that, you know, some people have been with us throughout the entire journey of our music career. You know, there's 40, 50, 60-year-olds there that brought their kids and told us they've been listening to us for a decade and now their kids love us as well, and to me that's gold.
The first time I could remember them was down in Coonabarra when we all had our 50cc motorbikes, and it was the first time her dad introduced us.
Yeah, that was like dumb enough for nosebleed section.
Yeah, when you run into the tree and break your collarbone.
Yeah, that one.
Like, it's all stuff we've all been through. They're rapping about things we've all done. They're rapping about doing the hard yards and, you know, washing dishes and doing jobs to kind of keep themselves afloat while they aspired to be what they are today. You know, it's amazing. They've gone from here to there, from small time to big time, to, you know, from doing little shows in pubs to doing All Phones Arena, you know?
Life tempo unsustainable. Try memo Walmart
days are full. Time and cruise till I can't escape it all. A dying hope of the unobtainable. Driving this road like a lucid dream. And sleep through the daytime, fly through the evening. If I don't dream and give life to my demons, please don't wake me, I'll die while I'm sleeping. Man, I swear I've never been here before. This pool is like a storm, blew me up on the shore. Don't know if I'm coming or going or who's running the show. And whether it's curtains or encore.
It's great to have a familiarity and that on-road camaraderie and just knowing what you've got with people. There's latitude when you need it, there's space when you need it, there's that companionship when you need it.
You know, you don't want to go to work with dicks, basically, you know what I mean? But everyone on this team, the crew, from the tour managers to the dudes that do the sound and the lighting guys, the gun, you know what I mean? Everyone's family, everyone's cool, man.
Especially with travel and touring and weird hours and, you know, just dealing with stuff. And if you're with people that are very even-tempered, you do build a different relationship than what you would if, you know, you're having beers with friends after work on a Friday or something, if you've got a 9-to-5 job or something, I'm assuming.
Don't really know, but, yeah, I'm assuming it's pretty different.
A lot of people think that being in a band or managing a band like that is all glamour and glitz and... at shows like this, it can appear like that, but there's a lot of bloody hard work that goes into it.
When I first joined on board, we had a discussion together where it's like, we're going to set the bar. Every time we go out, we want to set the bar higher and higher. It's all of us pulling our part, working towards a greater challenge every time, and that unfolding successfully in front of a live audience is a beautiful moment.
Melbourne, I need everybody in the building right now to put your cell phone in the air. I need you to light up the dark for me. So put them up now. So put them up now. Check. Every day you were born, you lost your load in the dark. The doctor said you had a hole in your heart. Just knew you were making room for a whole lot of heart. I loved you from the day until you saw it depart. You took your first breath upon my chest to build you a good nest before I left. It wasn't that I never loved your mother, but two happy homes are better than one that suffered. Every regret in this life that I made, I've been tempered by the strength in your eyes every day. I know you never said that you'd like me to stay. Still I'm sorry I neglected you while I was away. You were 8 when we headed to casualty, and no chance to face that death or mortality. You told me patience, strength and morality, and I'd burden this weight instead of you happily that night. You asked, would you die from your sickness? Why had I chosen your life out of millions? You filled me with the pride that was missing. Roaming, crying, but like a type of resilience. Only when it's dark, have a sign of surprise. For your fight, you go hard, there'll be scars for life. But you, a brave little soul, came in the cold like a fight. I hope you find the same flame when you roll.
Fall asleep.
I wrote this this where you slept in a hospital bed. Know this, your breath at the cost of my breath. I forgo this life that you want on my death. If you could know what it's like to live long and regret. So you could fight, you could shove, you could bleed and hurt. You could cry, you could love, learn your creed at work. And your stripes act dumb, that your teeth worse. And take a wife to become your sky, sea and earth. But these are things that you never see. But no, I'll just be here to set you free. Most of us won't understand the hell in which you've been in. Still they're wrestling with a demon. But take heart to be brave, we firstly fear. Same heart for seeing pain,
yet persevere will serve you.
I know this world is of course unfair and hurt you. But these virtues are yours to bear. I made you lion-hearted the day you're born. They say the night is darkest before the dawn. I'll take your hand upon this path. You can light a spark and we can find some calm in a raging storm. Ain't nothing left to scare you, see. We can live life and cherish every breath we breathe. No matter where you go, no, I'll never leave. Cause even when we go, we live it in a memory. So live on. Take your pain on, on survival. Lay awake through darkest skies. I say your name, you cast a light. You're a flame on a starless night. And I didn't know I was lost to your family. I didn't know I was locked here without keys. But we can walk across all these boundaries. You and me, nothing here to stop you. You're now free. So I wrote this to give you hope for every good thing in life you live to know. They say cancer survivors a gift of hope. Isn't so.
We love playing music and that's why we do what we do, and projects like this are really exciting for us. They're a bit different.
Just the atmosphere in the room, it's just buzzing. And so the orchestra love it, the choir loves it. Like, it's a pretty phenomenal experience, really.
I've seen a lot of smiles on stage coming from them because they're having fun and they're seeing a crowd that are losing their mind.
I think when the curtains opened and the house lights were up and you turn around and you go, oh wow, okay, there's thousands of people there and they're very excited. That's a really nice personal moment.
It is incredibly uplifting. I mean, it doesn't matter what you're playing. I mean, it might be very simple or quite complicated, but the vibe from the crowd is just overwhelming. It's great.
It's great for them because, you know, it's not as highly pressured as a normal orchestral concert, and they can actually get, you know, sort of be more physical about their enjoyment as well on stage. And I think they like that. Some people really like that.
Please make some noise for Hamish McKeach and the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra.
One thing that has always been a really great indicator for me is when you watch people in the crowd at a show, and it's not about so much what the band is doing for me, but to watch the people in the front row who are going crazy.
But I always take a moment to look around and see the crowd cheering and really get that shivers down. I'm getting it now, actually. get the shivers down the back of the neck, because that's why we're all here. It's not me, it's not the guys on stage, it's everyone in the room creating that moment. And that's the special thing about live music, you know. I guess that's why I'm here, ultimately.
I'm not going anywhere until we rattle the keys to the motherfucking kingdom. We came and we conquered, they're praying apart. They're claiming they want some, they really don't want some. So you ain't living a monster, so I'm all we know. Just feel the thing that I die. I ain't stepping aside. Hilltop, hill, say you're coming now. Hilltop, hill, a little higher now.
you want to play a game with the Hilltop Hoods? I said, Melbourne, you want to play a game with the Hilltop Hoods? The game is simple, the game is easy, the game is this. Everybody, front to back, side to side, up top, all around, I want you to take off one item of clothing. I don't care if it's a shirt, shoe, sock, cardigan, Cosby sweater, cap. I don't even care if it's an item of clothing. Give you a purse, crotch, whatever the f***. Just grab something, put that shit in the air for me, Melbourne. Let me see.
I don't want to see too many crotches in the air.
I said crotch, for God's sake.
Yeah, check it out, Melbourne. What my man just said is, everybody take something off and hold it in the motherfucking air.
DJ Melbourne! Like a lead Muhammad, we conquer the brand of proper. They claim that they want to, they really don't want to. You and them are the monsters, so I'm rolling with all. It's still the day that I die. Try and step in the sky for one of you. Hilltop Hoods, take a turkey now. Hilltop Hoods,
one striking thing about the Hoods is that it's honest and people connect with it.
These guys were on top of the world, are on top of the world, and they're still some of the most ground level dudes you ever meet in your life. You know, people would have this whole completely different idea about guys who can sell out stadiums like this.
Ultimately, they're more human than rock stars, and that's the best thing about it. That's why we keep them around.
They're extremely loyal to each other. They have an unusual brotherhood and an innate understanding. I mean, I guess they're like brothers in some ways.
I think me, Saffron and Debris definitely have a unique friendship.
You know, we've shared a lot from happiness to, you know, families being sick and, yeah, all the smiles and all the tears.
If you have a life experience with anyone, whether it's like a near-death experience, like a gun getting pulled on you in Germany or something. You know, just we've seen everything through together.
We know what pisses each other off and how far to push it as a joke and, you know, where to give a shoulder to lean on when it's needed. And, yeah, I think it's a beautiful thing.
Definitely feel very lucky to have been able to take this and turn it into a career.
You know, this ride could end today and I'd be super grateful.
It's just, it's crazy how far it's come. It's, yeah, it blows my mind.
Where we frown, you wear a smile that wears me down to hear me out. Know that I waste
the time and I should have been replacing your last name and mine. But that mistake is what I believe in. Wear it like a songbird. Mine disappear, but it won't leave me. Carry you on my shoulders, never said you dare. Ferry you through the corners, never let you dare. Capturing sands like time through the back of my hand. Fuck a holder for a moment to a lap of this land. I'll console you for a moment, then be back in a glance. But I'm so far since we left with the road. The chest inside of the heavens implode. Searching for the next episode. Problem is to letting it go. Be like letting go of everything I treasure and know. Whenever I go, think your chest will explode. No matter with your heart, like Brandon Lee's death in the cloak. Try to understand where we lay, my head is my home. As your lover for this rap suit was ever involved. But if you feel that you're ever alone, standing in the same room as me, let's say it is so. You can't save me, I'm clean to this devilish world. But you're bravely willing to share. Thank you so much. You got a beautiful Melbourne, singing voice.
Please make some noise for the one, the only Hilltop Hoods!
To the wind in the taxi, 2 feet to the wind in the backseat, 2 beeps to the car in front of us, so one of us sending up rap round the chassis. Think about these rhymes of what they gave me. Sounds like the 12 with a microphone and 2 turntables saved me. Took me around the world and bore me home. And I've seen all these other crews bang too, not knowing all the ways people helped me. Might not ever get a damn thank you, but they're sure enough gonna get a you're welcome. Matter of fact, I ain't leaving. I was here first and I don't believe them. I was here bursting, listening to Primo with Gino with Thurston. I'm missing out on being there for people in person. Cause we don't sleep when we're working, we don't bleed when we're hurting. We wear a heart on our sleeve and I'm certain the room for the burden till we call the curtains. So feel me, feel me, feel me, feel me. Do you
Inside the core, the conglomerate's forces writing on the wall, lighted up on the porch. It's 1994, 5 months of the sources. A mighty, mighty roar from the crowd of voices. This. Went from going through courts in the liners to being known for the shows and the flyers. Playing packed rooms, heading to the back when you cool down my face with some ice from the rider. Looking out to a crowd full of lighters, and the day those lights had inspired us. You see me walking now, I'm a ghost, I'm gone.
Two sheets on a surface of water, a loose leaf running worthless and torn up. If I could do these words justice, you'd see how much it's worth at a fork for. Every kid that never got one mention, every little bit of love or affection. I'm done with pretending the sun is descending, and all good things must come to an end. Feels like sort of the day this is, nothing more than a thought entertainment biz. I'ma walk away with nothing, a limit to you something. I thought you more than I came here with. Feel me? Said I wasn't grateful for my life, for my friends, and for the faithful. It's been a ride, but it's been a few times that I felt a loose side when the effort was so painful. The rap gave me such a fire drain. In fact, maybe it touched my life, but things got a little crazy, and nobody would pay me the ends that plainly justify the means. A life I can see we've all been blind. It's hard to believe that all this time that I wore my heart on my sleeve with this art on the scene. Gonna be high when I leave that all behind. You feel me?
Shows on the fires, playing back rooms, heading to the back when you cool down my face with some ice from the rider. Looking out to a crowd full of lighters, and the day those lights had inspired us. You see me walking now, I'm a ghost, I'm gone. Went from going through courts in the liners to being known for the shows on the fires, playing back rooms, heading to the back when you cool down my face with some ice from the rider. Looking out to a crowd full of lighters, and the day those lights had inspired us. You see me walking now, I'm a ghost, I'm gone.
Blue winter sunlight, the dawn and go.
I'm a ghost, I'm gone.
Blue when it's done, night is on a soul.
I'm a ghost, I'm gone.
Nowhere to run, writing's on the wall.
I'm a ghost, I'm gone.
So when it come, rise before we fall.
I'm a ghost, I'm gone.
Blue winter sunlight, the dawn and go.
I'm a ghost, I'm gone.
Broken and done, dying on a soul.
I'm a ghost, I'm gone.
There's nowhere to run, writing's on the wall.
I'm a ghost, I'm gone.
So when it comes, rise, rise before you fall.
Went from going through courts in the liners to being known for the shows and the fires. Playing back rooms, heading to the back when you cool down my face with some ice from the rider. Looking out to a crowd full of lighters, and the day those lights that inspired us. You see me walking.